such great leaders over here. I'm sure the shaping of the future of the media industry is going to be great. The only question I have as an individual is, when do we see Dawn 3?
Oh dear. I'm not sure you want to answer that right now, Shahrukh. Perhaps this is not the right forum, but I'm sure Shahrukh will have an answer in the media for you very shortly. Make sure that it's about the development of the media industry,
excuse
please.
Me.
And let there be questions and pointed ones at that.
Vikram.
Where?
Yeah.
Sorry. Oh, you're against the light. Go ahead, sir.
Actually, I want to throw it open to Shahrukh and Ritesh. I wanted to know the future of cinema, theater, and the community viewing and experiential entertainment. Because of Netflix, YouTube, and this digital media is coming in, and because of the government policies of getting permissions, do you think media, cinema is on the way out?
Cinema is on the way out, you think?
I'm asking, what is the future for theatres and multiplex?
I don't think so. I think I read a piece by some really amazing, wonderful producers, directors, and business houses about what cinema theatres may look like over the years, plus what cinema will be. I think the movie itself will be the experience, you know, not the emotion parts of it that people connect to individually. You will be able to, I will come to you. I can answer the other one. I answer. Khatam to kar lo, bhai. Please. Mere ko aisa lagta hai ki the movie itself will become more interactive. And you will not be able to have that interaction, whether changing scenes or interacting with the cast and crew, with the visual effects and virtual reality that Arnab also mentioned. All this happening together will need a different kind of community viewing. It will not be only localized to platforms which are handheld or mobile. Theaters will become like drama theaters. Movies will come for 6 months. It won't be about Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Community viewing will be that you'll go sit like in an arena, 360 degrees, interactive movies will be shown to you which you can't watch at home. And then you'll go, not just rushing on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, but long term, like Phantom of the Opera. So I think theater and movies will change into that kind of community viewing instead of what we are. It's very difficult to imagine just now. Right now we think the hall hoga, aisa screen hoga.
You've seen it somewhere.
I've not seen it somewhere, I've dreamed it a lot of times.
Right. The lady over there.
Hello. Hello.
Oh, the mic has already traveled somewhere else.
So my name is Kapil Pawar. I'm the founder and CEO of Nomad in India Online Services Private Limited. Nomad in India is a startup recognized by Government of India and recommended by Science and Technology Park. And I would like to introduce you to this word, Nomad. I was very happy to listen to what you guys were sharing, because this word Nomad, when I say Nomad, it means a K-N-O-W-M-A-D. This word means a creative, imaginative, and innovative person who can work with anybody, anytime, anywhere. And our mission at Nomad in India is to convert every university graduate into a nomad.
You have a question for us, sir?
Sorry, sir?
Do you have a question for us?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
I wanted to ask you, what do you think about the future of university ecosystem and people that we are producing from universities? Because that is our biggest dividend. What do you think about our human resource, our graduate community, that can be the that can be our strength.
Are you specifically asking Shahrukh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, go ahead, sir.
Yes, sir.
So,
yeah, intelligent question. Arnab se pujo tum.
Nahi, sir. I believe that you are a true nomad, sir.
Mad ka pata hai, mujhe no wala part mujhe nahi pata hai, but
exactly, sir. I mean,
yeah, I mean, see, human resource is always going to be extremely important. However, the world becomes digitized, and I do find, you know, I mean, this is a very big discussion. You know, the kind of stuff that we are taught from beginning to end, the way we do admissions in it, and then we come out and look for jobs. I think there is a there are a lot of gaps along the way in all three phases of educating yourself and how we educate ourselves finally also. But I think a part of that will also change with the digital world. There will be a lot of self-teaching, apart from just leading and learning expertise and specialty jobs in the universities. And of course, there should be departments which are somehow creating that many jobs that you are studying for. It's kind of like a cinema, that we are creating a lot of films, but we just don't have an area to show them enough. So we have, I think, we are creating enough students and human resource, but perhaps we still have not been able to amalgamate them all into some kind of a job that can, you know, ideally, in an economy, jobs should outstrip the new entrants.
Yeah.
But that doesn't happen in any economy. It takes time, so I think we have to have patience, and students need to have patience and work towards it.